Now I will discuss about the composition of matter. Matter can be formed by the small particles. The small particles like atom and molecules. Let me discuss about atom. What is atom? The word atom. The word atom is derived from a Greek letter atomos, which means indivisible. It means indivisible. That means atom cannot be broken down. Atom is the smallest particles of an element. Smallest particle of an element. Atom is the smallest particle of an element which can take part in the reaction and may or may not have independent existence. Means some atoms, for their existence, they do not depend upon other atoms. The atom which do not depend upon the other atom for their existence, that type of atom is considered as they have independent existence. Some atoms have also independent existence. Some atoms do not have also independent existence. That means some depends upon other atom for their existence. Some do not depend other atoms for their existence. For example, take an example of atoms. There are basically thinking about two types of atoms. Some have independent existence. Some do not have independent existence. Example. Atoms which do not have independent existence. Do not have independent existence. Example is your oxygen, nitrogen, chlorine, etc. They do not have independent existence. Another example, suppose take atoms which have independent existence. For example, helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, iron, aluminium. These are the atoms which have independent existence. They do not depend upon other atom for their existence. As a result, we can write only oxygen, because O represents oxygen atom, but O2 represents oxygen molecule. We can write Fe, because Fe exists itself. Only one atom exists itself, so it is an independent existence. But oxygen and helium do not have independent existence, So oxygen belongs to atoms, no doubt, but it do not have independent existence. Iron having independent existence, they can again written like this, only one iron can be, but we can write oxygen like this. Oxygen is your O2. O2 is the stable form of oxygen. Iron is the stable form of iron. That is the two type consider. One is your independent existence, other atom having do not have independent existence. Another question also arises in your mind. Atoms can take part in the chemical reaction. Generally, if you want to write equation H2 plus O2 is H2. Here, oxygen is written in the molecular form, but it is a reaction. No doubt, when we want to represent a chemical reaction in terms of equation, chemical equation, generally we write a stable form of the elements. So it is bound to write O2, not O. But we think about the reactions. In the reactions, atoms take part, but molecules do not take part. But it is bound to write O, because when we write any chemical equation, we are bound to write a stable form. Not only write here in the molecular form, but the reaction will happen in the atomic form. So at first, before going to the reaction, when oxygen atom reacts, before oxygen molecule first break down, gives two oxygen atom, then oxygen atom combined with the hydrogen atom, like that. Hydrogen atom undergoes dissociation, gives two hydrogen atom, then the reaction will start. From the above discussion, it is clear that atom here may or may not have independent existence, but it can take part in the chemical reaction. So, give the examples of atoms which have independent existence already written. Helium, neon, argon, krypton, iron. These are the examples. Next is your atom is made by three subatomic particles, such as electron, proton, neutron. Electron, proton. Electron have negative charge. Proton is the positive charge. Neutron has nuclear, no charge. Electron present in the outside of the nucleus. Proton and neutron present in the nucleus. Atom is made by three subatomic particles, such as electron, proton. Next point is your atom is neutral. Atom is neutral. Clear? How it is possible atom is neutral? We know that in an atom, the nucleus has neutral and proton, and outside the nucleus, protons are there. This is your nucleus. And the electrons are surrounding to the nucleus. Again, we know that number of electrons equal to number of proton in an atom. Again, we also know that charge of electron equal to charge of proton. Number of electron is equal to number of proton. Charge of electron is equal to charge of proton. So total charge due to electron, that is your negative charge, is equal to the total charge due to proton, that is your positive charge. That means total negative charge is equal to total positive charge. Neutron has no charge, it is neutral. That means finally we can calculate that the charge of atom is neutral. Atom is neutral because we can write, because the number of electrons, that is your negative charge, because the number of electrons is equal to the number of carbon, that is your positive charge. In an atom.